Alright, so as you recall, everyone, hello, we are still in the Sea of Clouds. We are going to go look for Sir Emmanalian in Vursian Saran. I don't want to ride them out, because then you can't hear the music of the zone. So I will listen to that instead. Okay. Looks like he's up over here somewhere. Look at these Abdellas. Look, the leech is just hopping around. Players of FF11 should recognize that model, though. As this is a popular model in FF11. Hey, Silly, remember that giant worm we fought in Tarangai?
Wait, what?
Remember that giant worm we fought in Tarangai?
Don't remind me of this. The pain and suffering we went through trying to kill that worm. Although that was like honestly the biggest, like outside of like if you think of like Black Temple, the one Infernal, he's pretty big. Yeah. But like that was the biggest boss model I've ever seen in my life. He was like easily 50 yards long. And like 30 yards wide, and you could like hit his only hitbox point was like that one spot in the middle of his body, so you could like be inside him. It's so weird.
Yep. You survey the surrounding area for a time, but see no sign of Emmanalian. Alright. I also remember he had a propensity for blowing off our clothes.
Yeah. I was gonna say, PMN, if you watch no other Final Fantasy XI videos, just find that one and watch it. Once that is on. It's hilarious.
Ah, the Abyssy bosses were such a pain in the ass. I'm so happy to be done that area. Ah. You gotta love how upbeat the music is here in Sea of Clouds during the day. Kind of reminds me of Ragnarok music, actually. Alright, sharing screens. So this is PMN.
Mistress Prentice, Lord Emmanalian. Lord Emmanalian has been taken by the Vanu. They had my lord surrounded, a whole gang of them. Please, you must come quickly.
Alright, off we go. Rendezvous with Honoroy.
It'd be funny if he was surrounded by Paisas instead.
I agree. Look at that totem right there. The Vanu are showing their superiority over this area, their dominion. There is a Paisa right there, actually. I gotta leave group. Alright, everyone. Here we are. I gotta make sure I'm actually recording. I am. Okay. Actually, I should leave share screen on, though, because there'll probably be voices, so. Well, not voices, but chat.
Oh, you're gonna be level synced. Oh, you have to start your new monk quest, too.
Ah, that's true. I do gotta do that.
Very important. The Vanu must have taken him to that village. Mayhap to present to their chieftain? I will make haste to the Rose House and tell Lady Lynette what has happened. Yeah, by the time I return with aid, it may already be too late. Forgive me for asking, Mistress Prentice, but should you spy an opportunity to sneak past the sentries and rescue Lord Emmeline in my absence, I beg you to take it. I know he can be a trifle presumptuous and insensitive and, well, insufferable, but he doesn't deserve this.
Alright. Find a way to sneak past them, alright? Attacking them head on. I'll probably start the monk ones next week. After I'm done Seer Clouds. But to be honest, I think I'm already almost close. I think I'm close to being done. Seer Clouds as is.
Yeah, I mean, you wouldn't even have to do the level 52 one necessarily, but you know, dungeons are gonna open up, and people are gonna expect you to have.
Yeah, I know.
Abilities. So I was just thinking, like, the main monk quest that says, you know, oh, now we'll do more things with you.
Yeah, no, I know. So where am I headed? What does it actually say? Alright. I'm gonna fight. Alright, let's do this. These Gundu do not stand a chance at all. Or Bundu. Vanu. I guess that's what happens when you come here at level 58, almost. Okay. Trying to give me no indication of where I need to go. Oh, there's a congregation of dancing Vanu over there, so that has to be it. Okay. By the Fury, you're not going to eat me, are you? That's not what you do to prisoners, is it? Miro! Miro! I'm over here! Netherlings come to free prisoner? Spread word like thunder and cast them into the cloud sea! See you later. Bramble weed rope. That was thoroughly unpleasant. Netherlings slink away like guileful gillycats! Rally warriors of Gundu! Let none escape! Alright, let's do this. I like how I punched the crap out of that guy and they're still just going right after Emmeline. There we go.
Okay. Why does Lily always refer to herself in third person?
What is who?
Lily always refers to herself in third person.
Meryl hasn't done them yet.
Oh. Emily, you are literally the worst knight. If you can be referred to as a knight. Parshapot, the silver fuller, is like running way the fuck over there. Help has arrived, Miro! Horshapot, is that you? Thank heavens, get us out of here! Keep the Emmanalian safe, Miro. We will hold them off. I'll do my best. He's kind of a weakling, though. He's like the Konohamaru of Ishgard. Except weaker. Stop it! Yes, when getting attacked by Vanu, the best thing you can do is throw your arms up and yell, "Stop it." I keep saying Vanu, but Vanu are not these guys. These guys are Gundu. Gundu Vanu. This way, quickly! We did it!
Reinforcements?
Hoist. Mute, please.
Anger of Honu, chief of mighty Vondo! Royals like blackest storm clouds, offer netherlings to the white. Cloud sea swells, and he comes. The White! Mighty Bismarck! Lord of the Mists!
A flying whale? By the Fury, it's a primal! We must away! Bloody typical.
All right, we're going in.
Aye, Chief.
All aboard.
Indeed. All right, Sid. Hello. This might be worst. Nope.
The cults only know what might have happened had we not been around to save you. No need for thanks, though. It's not as if you haven't done the same for us on a few previous occasions. All right, more than a few. It was but blind chance that brought us together this time. In case you were wondering, the Holy See has petitioned the Ironworks for assistance with the creation of theirs, the Protector. Apparently, they just can't seem to get her flying. Anyway, I came to Camp Cloudtop to cast an eye over the ship, only to learn that you had arrived some few days before with an Ishgardian lordling in tow. Small world, I thought. Just as Sid Lordling's manservant skittered into view, babbling about his master having been captured and you risking all to rescue him. And the rest, as they say, is history. Right, well, I hate to cut short our reunion, but I am here on business after all, and the boys are already hard at work. Don't worry, old friend, we'll speak again soon, I promise.
Alright, Emmanalian. A reward long in coming. Lord Emmanalian appears to be rather pleased with himself. Very well, I admit it. It was an incredibly harrowing experience. I could very well have died, you know. Me, dead. On the other hand, by risking life and limb in the line of duty, I did succeed in uncovering the existence of a new primal. And that, old girl, is no small feat. I have made an historic discovery. A fact even Lady Leniette will have no choice but to acknowledge. Yes, I am rather looking forward to basking in the sunshine of her praise. Speaking of which, isn't it time we made our triumphant return? Alright, let's go make our triumphant return. See, isn't this area much better when you can actually see everything around? And here's Lady Leniette. Let me share screens with Pacament. There we go.
Praise Luna, I feared the worst. What happened out there? A primal? Are you sure? Yet, now that I think on it, this Bismarck is reminiscent of the white whale of Vanu legend, a massive creature said to swim in the sea of clouds.
From what I have learned of comparable summonings, the presence of the Vanu's god would certainly explain the sudden change in their behavior towards the people of Clown Cloudtop.
You mean to say that they have fallen under the primal's influence? I recall reading of such things in the documents provided by Master Alphenold.
Aren't we forgetting something important, Lady Leniette? A little recognition for the hero of the hour, a few choice expressions of gratitude, respect, admiration, and so on.
Why, yes, you're right, of course. Mistress Prentice deserves all that and more for having risked her life to rescue such an esteemed personage.
Well, if there's naught else to discuss, I would depart for Ishgard forthwith. The Holy See and the Temple Knights must be informed of this new threat without delay.
But of course, Mistress Prentice, you have done more than enough here. Pray return to Ishgard with Lord Horshapont and give my warmest regards to the court.
So that's it then. No more forays into enemy territory. Well then, I can see my services are no longer needed. Take care, Lady Lynette. May our next meeting take place under more felicitous circumstances. All's well that ends well, eh? To the airship landing, then. We can speak on the journey home. Ah, Horshafant, ever a staunch ally. Alright, I guess we're just gonna teleport to the pillars because I'm lazy as shit. And as I cannot fly yet, it makes sense for me to do so. The first video's quality is over an hour long. And the second, the other two is with OBS and 1080p. So oftentimes, Yusuf, I find that the recordings that I make don't reflect what actually gets streamed, because I find that they end up being better quality. Okay. Here's Horshfont. I confess, I have always been rather fond of airship travel. The chill of the wind upon your face, the warmth of the blood pumping in your veins from excitement, I find the whole experience indescribably invigorating. Or mayhap it is simply the joy of having cheated death yet again? Haha! In any event, I must make for the congregation and inform Sir Emmerich of all that has occurred. Emmanalian should have returned to the manor by now. Why not go and see if he has recovered from his ordeal? Alright, let's go to the House Fortaunt Manor. We've gotten off to a pretty good start in Ishgard today. We found out about a new primal. We completed the Sea of Clouds for the most part. Shit, I just went the wrong one. For the most part, we did Little Ladies Day. All pretty good.
I made baller status near Eastern Antiques.
It's true. And one day you will be legendary in the Pioneers Guild, too.
Nope.
This guy just wants to let me inside. Alright. Don't know if this is voiced or not. It's not. Oh, it's you, Miro. Gods, did he have to strike me so hard? Father, he did not approve of how I handled matters in Camp Clattop, how I endangered the lives of others through my own recklessness and incompetence. It's not easy playing the hero, is it? Well, that wasn't the only thing I remember. I'm gonna strength 4. Alright. So the only other thing we can do now is we've got 18 minutes left to stream. So, I am going to go back to Uldah, and I'm gonna start up the monk quests. Next week we will do the other son's quests, which will lead us to Falcon's Nest. So, let's go to Uldah. And we are going to, I believe, that the Goldsmith Guild? Is that right? I think it's the Goldsmith Guild. Ah, yes, this looks right. The legend continues. Hello, Eric. It's been a long time. The legend continues. Professor Eric is concerned for a mutual friend, though he would be the last to admit it. Ah, Miro, your sense of timing is impeccable as ever. A pity your mind was never quite so reliable. But worry not, for the task I would have you perform shan't tax your limited intellect. It pertains to your monk friend, Vidogelt. This scarce comes as any surprise, but my words of wisdom have struck a chord with the oath. Having been made to realize that there is more to life than vengeance, he now expands his energies on more constructive pursuits, namely rebuilding his order, the Fist of Rauger. Indeed, he has been taking on pupils, and rumor has it, he teaches with both charisma and zeal. Plainly, my own brilliance as a tutor has rubbed off on him. And what is this task that I would have you do? Take more readings with my aetherometer, you are doubtless thinking. False! You of all people should know that I am finished with that research, and such a triumph it was! To be sure, I may have need of your talent for fieldwork again in the future. For now, I simply wish for you to go and see how Vildegard fails. And lest you think I should worry about the fool, perish the thought. As a sister of the path, you will be worried about him, though it may not have occurred to you yet. So I am taking the liberty of telling you what you must do to alleviate that worry. Vidergelt trains his pupils in Revenant's Toll. With that, you have all the information you need. Off you go then. Alright, so we're gonna go to Mordona. Technically, we're not allowed in Mordona right now since the issue with the Scions occurred. Okay. Vidergelt is up there. If you recall, Silly, you were the voice of Vidergelt.
Nope.
And PMS gonna have people to voice in this quest line, if I remember correctly.
Miro, it has been a while, sister. What brings you here? So, the professor sent you. But it matters not why you came. I am glad for your visit. Indeed, I have begun teaching. A desire to preserve our way, to impart our art to a new generation, though I myself still have much to learn. I have but a few pupils now, but slowly their numbers grow. I will introduce some to you, two girls who show great promise. Perhaps you can assist in their training. Zensa, Ochaka.
What is it, Master Hoodergirl? Has someone new joined?
No, not a new pupil, an old one. My first and foremost. She has long surpassed me. Miro is her name. Today you will train under her supervision. An excellent opportunity. Go to the usual place and make ready.
I've always wanted to have a senior. See you in a bit, Miro. Sansa, wait. Please excuse Sansa. She forgets herself sometimes, but she has a good heart. You shall be honored for your watchful gaze, Miro.
Those two were abandoned by their parents. One day, they came and begged me to teach them. They are very dedicated. Very quickly do they learn. Every day is fulfilling. But come, let us go to the training ground. Meet me southeast of Revenant's Toll.
Alright. So, I know it's been a long time since I did any of the monk quests, but if you recall, Vidogelt is the guy we fought at the end of the monk quest who gave us our monk outfit chest piece, and we learned Dragon Kick from beating him. Well, that's not something you say every day. And if you recall, this is actually where we fought him before. Right in this area.
We have no dedicated place for training. No halls of our own. My pupils train wherever they can. First, I would have you demonstrate your abilities to Dizenza. She awaits you to the northeast.
Alright. Got a paladin there, messing up some leave quests. And here's Zenza.
I've been waiting for you. Master thinks very highly of you, so you'd better not disappoint. Whoa, you really are strong. And there I was feeling good about myself. The world's a big old place, isn't it? So you're going to demonstrate for Chaka next? He's going to be so impressed. We've been together all our lives, in case you're wondering. We can read each other's thoughts as though they were our own. Come on, I'll take you to her. She should be over to the south.
All right. Oh, she's fighting two snakes. All right, let's talk to Dizenza first.
Hurry in, show Chaka your skills. I have eagerly awaited your coming, Mistress Miro. Zenza tells me that I'm in for a treat, and I mustn't so much as bat an eyelid. My heart races in anticipation of your demonstration. Please begin whenever you're ready.
Sorry.
You're every bit as amazing as Zenza claimed you would be. Even though Master said so himself, I didn't believe that anyone could be stronger than him. See? You're impressed by... You impressed the britches off her, just like I said you would. Oh, Zenza, I've never been so excited. I wish to learn everything Mistress Miro knows. Everything. Me too, Chaka. With her help, we're bound to become stronger than we'd ever dared hope. Growing up on our own, Zenza and I suffered much because we were weak and couldn't protect ourselves. And so we swore to one another that we would become strong. If we could be as strong as you, there would be naught we need to fear. So, I've been wondering about the applications of the One Elm Punch.
Who are you? What do you want?
That was Master Ritter Goat.
Alright. Man, he's got quite the yell on him.
Sorry, I fell asleep.
Well, fortunately, we have 7 minutes left, so stay awake. Alright, we're gonna talk to Desensa first.
Master, are you alright?
And Vittergeld.
You have not come to harm.
We're fine, Master. It's you were worried about what happened.
Strangers came. They attacked without warning. The techniques they used were the same as ours.
Same as ours? You mean to say they were monks? But I thought there were no others besides ourselves.
I alone survived the massacre at the temple. There should be no... the sensation. A new power swells within me, as though a new chakra has opened. Yet it is unlike aught I have ever felt before.
Fuck, this area was the site of some famous battle, wasn't it? Yes, it was. The Battle of Silver Tear Skies, which means that one's chakra can be opened here. Judging by Master's condition, however, I'm inclined to think that something else was the cause.
Let us return to Revenant's Toll. I must rest.
Use of monks, there's the Miro, which is the best. Well, Miro is here, and she is the best. At least amongst those present. Because I've already bested Vittergeld, and the other two are just fledgling monks, so... Alright, Vittergeld, let's do this.
I am feeling better. The pain has subsided. They came shortly after you left. Masked men who fight as we do. They were monks, of this I am certain. They outnumbered me. I held them off, but a sudden pain racked my body, as though I was pierced through. I fell to my knees. When next I was aware, my assailants were gone. Most likely fled when they heard your coming. The sensation I felt, it is not unlike a chakra opening, but neither is it the seventh chakra. If it isn't the seventh chakra, then what could it possibly be? I know not. I must ask someone more learned than me. Professor Eric, he is versed in the history of our order. Perhaps he can find more information. Sensa. Chuck, return to your training. Mira, this may be a new source of power. If so, I would share its secrets with you. If I learn something, I will let you know.
The next month's quest will be available from Vildegard upon reaching level 52. The requirements for undertaking subsequent quests can be viewed in your journal. Alright, so we're not going to pick that up. Okay, just level 58. Excellent. So, the bonus points. But yeah, we just hit level 58. Excellent. We're not going to pick this up right now, as that's going to be the end of the stream for today. But that said, thank you very much for joining today, everyone. Miro will give us a nice wave. Silly and I will be starting our stream tomorrow at noon, an hour early, and finishing at 5. So, 2 extra hours of FF11. We're going to try and get through as much of Adolin as we can for the hell of it. That said, from there, Dragon Quest VIII will take place again on Monday. So again, thank you for viewing, everyone. Have a good one. We shall see you later.